So last session I am discussing about your cable bridges. So in cable bridge I discuss your suspension bridge. So this is your cable stay bridge. I discuss also these things. So cable stay bridge may appear to be similar to your suspension bridge, but they are quite different in principle and their construction. So in suspension bridge, large main cables, normally two, hang between the tower and are anchored at pitch end to the ground. Next, this can be difficult to implement when ground conditions are poor and the main cable, which are free to move on bearing in the towers. So bear the load of the bridge deck before the deck is installed. So the cables are under tension from their own weight along the main cables. The smaller cables are not connected to the bridges. So which is lifted in section as this is done. The tension in the cable increase as it nudge with the live load of the traffic crossing the bridge. So the tension in the main cable is transferred to the ground at the anchorage and by downwards compression of the towers. So I discussed the thing that is we have two main towers. We have two major classes of cable stay bridge. One is your harp and another is your fan. In the harp or parallel design, the cables are nearly parallel so that the height of their attachment to the towers is proportional to the distance from the tower to their mounting on the deck. So we have different types of bridge. That is your suspension bridge and that is your cable stay bridge. So here if you see I just draw a diagram. Just wait. This is how our suspension bridge will differ from our this. Just wait. I erase this. So here, if you see. Here we have two lines, one is this line and another is this line. So here what we see, here if this bridge looks like, here this looks like this manner. So here also looks like this manner. So here it looks like this manner. So basically this is a kind of your suspension bridge. So this is your suspension bridge. I just mark all the 11 points. So here we have cables, here also we have cables. Here also we have cables. These are all our cable supported. So here we have also cables. Here also we have different cables. So these are the different types of cable we use for this suspension. So here this is also a different kind of cable. Here also we have different kind of cable, which we use to make our this suspension bridge. So this is the kind of suspension bridge. So this is your suspension bridge. So this is your suspension bridge. S-U-S-P-E-N-S-I-O-N. So this is your suspension. This is your suspension. Here if you see, this is your suspension bridge. So this is your suspension. So SPSI 1. So basically this is the kind of your suspension bridge. So how we differentiate our cable strap bridge with suspension bridge? So this is your suspension bridge. So here I also draw your cable strap bridge. So just wait. So I'll just draw your cable strap bridge. So if you see, this is the deck of your bridge. Now this is the tower. Also this is the tower. So here we connect each tower with the cable. So here its pattern is like a triangular pattern. So it looks like this pattern. Now here also this tower is connected with the cables. So here it is connected like this manner. So from this we just connect all the cables from this tower top point. So here we connect another cable. Here we connect another cable. Here we connect another cable. Now here we also start connecting the cables in this direction also. So here we start connecting other cables. Here also we start connecting another cable. Here we also start connecting another type of cable. Also here we connect another type of cable. Here also we connect another type of cable. Now here we connect one type of cable. Here we connect another type of cable. And here we also connect the different type of cable. So it is our cable strap bridge of fan design. So here I am writing, this is our cable strap bridge. So basically this is our cable strap bridge of fan design, and its design is like fan, so it is looks like a fan design. Cable strap bridge, and it is of fan design. It is a kind of fan design. It is a cable strap bridge of fan design. Next, in cable strap bridge, the tower are the mainly load bearing structure that transmit the bridge loads to the ground. Also, a cantilever approach is often used to support the bridge deck near the towers, but lengths further from them are supported by cable running directly to the towers. That has a disadvantage, unlike for the suspension bridge, that the cables pushed to the sides as opposed to the directly up, and it also requires the bridge deck to be stronger to resist the resulting horizontal compression loads. But it has the advantage of not requiring firm anchorage to resist the horizontal pull of the main cables of the suspension bridge. So by designing, all static horizontal forces of the cable strap bridge are balanced so that the supporting tower do not tend to tilt or slide, and so must only resist horizontal force from the live loads. So these are all about your I think different type of bridge, and also I discussed that how your bridge look like. So is it clear to everyone? Sabko samajh mein aa gaya? Sabko samajh mein aaya? Okay, theek hai, to ye bhi mat bolo. Next designs. So there are four major classes of rising on cable strap bridge, that is your mono, har, fan and star. So there are four major classes of ringing on cable strap bridge. First is, so here we discuss the design part. So here we discuss the design part of our, so design of, so next is our designs. So there are four major classes of ridging on cable strap bridge. First is mono. So first is our monotype. Second is our harp. Second is our harp. third is our fan. Third is our fan. And fourth is our star. So these are four classes of or four designs of power. Four designs of power. Cable, stay, bridge. So first is your mono, second is your harp, third is your fan, and fourth is your star. So basically the mono design. So basically this design use a single cable from its tower and is one of the lesser used example of the class. Next is harp. So in the harp or parallel design, the cable are nearly parallel so that the height of their attachment to the tower is proportional to the distance from the tower to their mounting on the deck. Next is our fan design. So I discussed these two design. Next is your fan design. So what is our fan design? So in the fan design, basically the cable all connect to or pass over the top of the tower, and the fan design is structurally superior with a minimum movement applied to the towers. But for practical reasons, the modified fan, also called the semi fan, is preferred especially, and also I'm discussing that. But for practical reasons, the modified fan is preferred especially when many cables are necessary. So in the modified fan arrangements, the cable terminate near the top of the tower. So near the top of the tower, and it is also spaced from each other sufficiently to allow better termination, improved environmental protection, and good access to individual cable for maintenance. Next and last one is in the star. So in the star design, another relatively rare design, the cables are spaced apart on the tower like the harp design, but connected to one point or a number of closely spaced points on the deck. So we have different types of our design for cable stay bridge. So how mono design, how harp design, and how fan design looks like. I give you all the pictorial representation of all the designs. So just wait. This is the deck of my bridge or my cable stay bridge. This is the tower. So this is the tower. From this tower, on the top of the tower, only one cable will be given. So you all see this type of, just wait, you all see different kinds of bridge. So if you see this bridge, so this bridge is your situated in Bangkok. So this bridge design is a fan type design. So this is your cable stay bridge. So this is your cable stay bridge, and the design of this bridge is cable. This bridge is your cable stay bridge. Cable stay bridge. And also cable stay bridge. And also this bridge is looks like your fan design bridge. Fan design. Fan design. Fan design. Because here you see in the fan design, the cable all connect to or pass over the top of the tower. So here you see this here. This is the top of the tower. This is the top portion of the tower. This basically part is the top portion of the tower. So here all the cables, here you see this cable, this cable, this cable, this cable, this cable, this cable, also in this direction, this cable, also this cable, also this cable, this cable, this cable, all the cables will pass through, all the cables will pass over the top of the tower. And the fan design is superior with a minimum moment applied to the tower. So here minimum moment is applied to the tower, but for various reason or also but for the practical reasons, a modified fan, also called as semi fan, is preferred. So especially where cables are necessary, in the modified fan arrangement, the cable terminates near the top of the tower but are spaced from each other sufficiently to allow better termination, improved environmental protection, and good access to the individual cable for maintenance. So this is a kind of your fan design. So just see here. Here only one cable will pass from the tower. So if only one cable will pass from the tower, it is your mono design. Here also only one cable will pass from the tower. So this is your mono design. This is your mono design. Next, we have arc design or we have parallel design. So here, if you see, this is the deck, this is the tower, and also this is the tower. Also on this tower, here this cable is passing, also in this direction 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 this cable is passing, also from here this cable is passing. Next, for this tower also many cables are passing. So here also one cable is passing. Also here another cable is passing. Also here one cable is passing. Also here another cable is passing. Also here another cable is passing. Another cable is passing. Also here another cable is passing. Also here another cable is passing. So this is a kind of your harp design. So this is harp or parallel, because if you see, all the cables are generally parallel. So this is also your harp design. Basically, this is your harp design. This is your harp design. Or this is also known as your parallel design. This is your parallel design. Next is our fan design. So how our fan design looks like? So here, if you see how our fan design looks like. So this is the deck, this is the tower, also this is the tower. From here all the cables are passing from the top of the tower. So all the cables are passing from top of the tower. Here this is the cable. Here also in this direction this cable is passing, also in this direction this cable is passing, also in this direction from here this cable is passing, also from this direction this cable is passing, here also this cable is passing, also from this direction this cable is passing, also from this, sorry, on top, from top this cable is passing, from top this cable is passing, also from top this cable is passing, also this cable is passing. So it is a kind of your fan design. So this is a kind of your fan design. Fan design. Fan design. So this is a kind of your fan design. Next is our star design. So here you all see, this is your mono design. This is your mono design. This is your heart design. This is your fan design. Next type of design for our cable stay bridge is star design. So how our star design looks like, I just draw your star design. So here you wait, in this mono design I just modify it. So here it terminates at a single point. So here also this cable terminate at a single point. So here this cable also terminate at a single point. Here also this cable terminates at a single point. Here also this cable terminate at a single point. So here if you see, this cable terminate at a single point. Here also this cable terminate at a single point. Here also this cable terminate at a single point. Here also this cable terminate at a single point. Next, if you start, then here also this cable is terminated from a single point. Here also this cable is terminated to a single point. Here also this cable is terminated to a single point. Here also this cable is terminated to a single point. Here also this cable is terminated to a single point. Here also this cable is terminated to a single point. Here also this cable terminated to a single point. Here also this cable is terminated to a single point. Here also this cable is terminated to a single point. So this is basically your star design. This is basically your star design. This is basically your star design. This is your star design. So basically we have four different types of design of our cable stay bridge. So I discussed all the things. So there are also four arrangement of support column, that is your single, double, portal or A-step. So the single arrangements use a single column for cable support, normally protecting through the center of the deck, but in some cases located on one side or the others. Next is your double arrangement. So the double arrangement place pair of column on both side of the deck. Next is your the portal is similar to the double arrangement, but has a third member connecting the tops of the two column to form a door-like shape or portal. So this offer additional strength, especially against your transverse loading. Next is your the A-shape design. So the A-shape design is similar in contact to the or concept to the portal, but achieved same goal by angling the two column towards each other to meet at the top. So eliminating the needs for the third member, the inverted Y design combines the A-shape on the bottom with the single on top. So these are basically different designs of our cable stay bridge. So next is your, these are the different types of bridge. I discussed these things. This is here if you see, this is also a kind of your, here if you see, this is the top of the tower. This is the top of the tower. And also from the top, all the cables are originated and come to at a particular point. So here also, this is your cable stay bridge. So this is your cable stay bridge. And the type of this bridge is, this is also a kind of, this design is known as your harp design. This is a harp design. Here, this is the tower. This is the tower, and also this is the pier. This bottom part is our pier. Yes. So these are basically our different cable bridge. Next is our advantage of suspension bridge. So what are the various advantage of suspension bridge? So first advantage is suspension bridge. First advantage is suspension bridge has a high strength to bed ratio. So if you calculate the bed to strength ratio, the cable bridge has high strength to the bed ratio. Next, they are flexible. So in your first session I discussed these things, that these are flexible, and it is also its disadvantage, because if it is flexible, then if it deform, then in many cases it deform permanently, and in many cases after application of load they come in their elastic position or their original position. So it is also advantage for us. Next, and can span long distance with no pier. Therefore, good on very high places across water, etc. So basically, we prefer the both the bridge, that is your suspension bridge, and it may be your cable stay bridge. We prefer the both type of bridge across our water body or across our river. So they require little access from above hiding construction. Next is they can be very thin and therefore less visuals. So basically, this bridge is very thin. So very thin and therefore less visible. This is also less visible kinds. They have an elegant look. So it have an elegant look. So the area spent by the suspension bridge is very long in proportion to the amount of material required to construct bridge. So these are various points which we have to keep in mind during discussing the advantage of our suspension bridge. Next is disadvantage of suspension bridge. So we have also various disadvantage of suspension bridge. First one is our disadvantage of suspension bridge. So first one is our flexibility disadvantage. Next one is your foundation disadvantage. Next one is your heavy loads. So what are flexibility disadvantage? So suspension bridge are flexible, which is an advantage until condition becomes severe, instability in extremely turbulent condition, or during strong earthquake may require temporary closures. So in 1914, high winds caused the Tamaco narrow bridge near Seattle, Washington to collapse. So here, this disadvantage property of our suspension bridge will also couch or also damage our suspension bridge. So you see here that in 1940 high winds, so if the intensity of wind is high, then it may be possibility that in suspension bridge that wind will affect our bridge, so it may be collapsed. So you have to keep in mind that this is a disadvantage of our suspension bridge, and also flexibility is also a disadvantage for our suspension bridge. So but if you do not allow flexibility in your suspension bridge, then your suspension bridge will not meet. So generally we prefer our flexibility in a certain manner. Next is your foundation disadvantage. So what are different foundation disadvantage? So when built in soft ground, suspension bridge require extensive and expensive foundation work to combat the effect of the heavy loads on foundation tower. Next is heavy loads. So flexibility also become a disadvantage when heavy concentrated loads are involved, and suspension bridges are not generally used for regional rail crossing that carry maximum weight loads, which add dangerous stress to the structures. So this is all disadvantage of your suspension bridge. So here you see, this is a kind of your suspension bridge. So basically, this is a kind of your suspension bridge. So here I'm writing, this is a kind of your suspension bridge. This is your suspension bridge. So this is your suspension bridge. So this is support suspension page. Next, what are the advantage of cable stay bridge? So here you see, this is the advantage of our cable stay bridge. So first advantage is the cable stay deck is in compression pulled towards the tower and hatch to be stiff at all stage of construction and usage. So this is the first advantage of our cable stay bridge. Next is a great advantage of the cable stay bridge is that it is essentially made of cantilevers and can be constructed by building out from the towers. Next is cable stay bridge possess higher stiffness and display a smaller deflection when compared with suspension bridge. So this bridge will show you a smaller deflection. So if you calculate the deflection for your suspension bridge, so here if we have deflection for suspension bridge, then the deflection of your suspension bridge is more than the deflection of your cable stayed bridge. So here I am writing CSB, that is your cable stay bridge, and this is your deflection at your suspension bridge. So cable stay bridge possesses higher stiffness and display smaller deflection when compared with suspension bridge. So construction time is less for cable stay bridge. So basically the construction time is less for your cable stay bridge because you have to construct a deck, and on firstly you have to construct a pier. So you construct a pier, then on that pier you construct a tower. So here you construct a tower. Also here just you construct a pier, on that pier you construct a tower. On that tower you just allow all the strings and all the cables to connect with the deck of the bridge. So here just in less time we generally construct this type of cable stay bridge. So cable stay bridge required less cable. Also it required less cable because if you compared with your suspension bridge, then you see here this is your tower. So here you required, here this looks like this and it also looks like this. So here we require less more number of cable, because also for this particular direction you connect that main cable with your vertical cable from both the sides. So here you connect these cables on both the sides. So here the requirement of cable is more as compared to your cable required for your cable stay bridge. So these are the various points or various advantage of our cable stay bridge. Next we have to see what are the various comparison. So we compare our suspension bridge with cable stay bridge and see all the relevant points of our cable stay bridge and suspension bridge. So just see here, so here we have a comparison between our suspension bridge and cable stay bridge. So you have to keep this comparison in your mind, because it may be possible that in your university examination this question may be asked from your cable structure, that what are the different types of cable. I discuss in first session what do you mean by cable structure. I also discuss what are the different type of cable structure. We have two type of cable structure. One is your suspension bridge cable structure. Next is your cable stay bridge. Next I am discussing what do you mean by suspension bridge. I also show you different type of suspension bridge. Then I discuss cable stay bridge. I also give you the different type of designs of your cable stay bridge. I discuss mono type, I discuss fan type, I discuss hard type, I discuss star types. So I discuss all the technical aspects of your different types of cable stay bridge design. Next I'm discussing about what are the different advantage and what are the different disadvantage of our these two type of bridge. So I discuss advantage and disadvantage also. Next we have a comparison between cable and suspension bridge. So you keep this all the things in your mind, because this is important for your examination. So just here you see, so here I am bifurcating with a line. So here you see, first point is cable bridge, sorry, your suspension bridge is normally limited to two towers. So basically this suspension bridge is normally limited to two towers. Next is your cable stay bridge lies in the fact that it can be built with any number of towers. So you remember that your suspension bridge will made up of only two towers. So if you see in diagram, just wait. Here you see, this is a bridge, Golden Gate Bridge, San Francisco. So here if you see, we have two towers. Here you see this tower across the river. Here also we have a tower across the river. So basically, for this is your kind of suspension bridge. So for making this suspension bridge across this river, we just made two towers. One tower is this, so this is a tower. Here this is one tower, and also another tower is made on another side. So for suspension bridge, we generally made two towers. Next, for our cable stay bridge, we just construct any number of towers. So here I am discussing this basic comparison between our suspension bridge and our cable stay bridge. So this is the first point you have to keep in mind. Next, just wait. So it requires any number of towers. So here you see that it requires built with any number of towers. Next, our suspension bridge require more cables, cable stay bridge require less cable. Next is construction time is longer for suspension bridge, but construction time is less for cable stay bridge. Next is your suspension bridge possess less stiffness and display large deflection when compared with your cable stay bridge. Next is your cable stay bridge possess higher stiffness and display a smaller deflection when compared with your suspension bridge. So these are the various points you have to keep in mind during the analysis of your suspension and cable stay bridge. Last points. So the deck of suspension bridge is usually suspended by vertical hangers through, but the structure is initially flexible and great effort must be made to withstand the effect of traffic and wind. Next is your the greater inherent rigidity of triangulated cable stay bridge compared with the suspension type makes life easier for their designer and builders. Next is a suspension bridge is not made of cantilever. So you remember this thing, that your suspension bridge is not made of a cantilever, but a great advantage of cable stay bridge is that it is initially made up of cantilever and can be constructed by building out from the towers. So these are different points you have to keep in mind during the study or during the analysis of your cable structures. So I discuss all the technical aspects of your cable structures. So this is all about your cable structures. So in next class or in next classes, I am discussing about your truss. So I ending my session. So thank you.